Hey, Nick Thomas here at the 11th Annual National Cyber Summit in Huntsville, Alabama. I'm joined here by Mr. Jerry Jenkins. He is the Director of Cybersecurity at CGI Federal here in Huntsville, Alabama. And he's going to be doing one of the lightning round talks today about security operations centers. So welcome, Jerry.
Welcome.
Nice to have you on.
Glad to be here.
Can you tell us a little bit about CGI Federal and what services you provide to your customers?
Sure. CGI Federal is a portion of CGI that is focused on a lot of the federal space and a lot of the different services that are unique to the federal market. We do everything from SOC and SOC automation to high-end consulting compliance authorizations and things of that nature. So basically anything you need in terms of assessment, in terms of security operations, building, management, engineering, architecture, all of that, we take care of that for our customers, soup to nuts, essentially.
And how many security operations centers do you have?
We have several. The ones that are focused on federal, there's three of those that we use right now. We have several of those that we use. We also work across the functions for the rest of the CGI to help support and share some of the broader knowledge of the things that we learn so that we help the corporation and our customers by extension. Even though we can't necessarily share everything we're doing on the federal space,
right,
we can help with some of the practices and enhancing that kind of stuff to make sure that, hey, we're doing things with the best possible processes we can.
Which in turn helps out the government, obviously, and then commercial, and then people,
yes,
you know.
Yes, the other industries as well. But
okay,
you know, like I said, we're focused mainly on the federal, so we do a lot with that, and we are actually working in shifting things and helping people move and do migrations from the physical data centers and things like that that are the traditional models into some of the cloud-based models, and making sure that as they're pushing to go to the cloud, we're able to help them migrate and get things set up the way they want to do. So we focus a lot on that. We've had a lot of federal customers come to us and ask for help doing that. We've got some specific tools and processes that we use that help them do that in probably the most expedient way they're going to find anywhere.
And helping them secure their cloud, right?
That is the idea,
That is the idea. So can you give us a little hint about what you're going to talk today about in your Lightning Talk?
Oh, sure. Lightning Talk today is going to be about security operations centers and moving from a standard model that is more reactive up through something that's proactive, but going proactive into something that is predictive. And we're talking about things that are based on intelligent automation and moving beyond just gathering all of this data and taking this data and turning it into something that is actually useful. Because you can have terabytes and terabytes of data coming in a day. If you don't have anything that you can actually turn into actionable intelligence and use, then it doesn't really do you any good. You can collect everything you want, but unless you're actually able to sift it into something you can do something with, you're not going to be able to do anything.
And there's a lot of network traffic that goes through customer networks every day. So terabytes and terabytes of data, it gets piled up in storage bins, right? What do you do with that data? You don't have enough people to sit there and go through it. So you obviously must have some type of machine learning or artificial intelligence procedures or stuff that you're going through. And you talked about it going from reactive, proactive to predictive. So that's sort of like past, present, and future. So you guys are going forward into the future.
Exactly. Yeah. The biggest goal here is, as you're probably well aware, trying to get the right cybersecurity talent and make sure that you're able to retain them and apply things is a challenge. And especially in a critical area like the SOC type work, it's very, very hard to get and retain quality people. And so you've got to make sure that you're making sure that they don't burn out, that they're getting an opportunity to learn and enhance those new skills as they come in, because those are things that only people can do. At the same time, if you've got all of these data and all of these logs that are coming in and all of that stuff actually can be scanned and interpreted by a computer, then let's do that. Let's take that, because they're very good at looking at repetitive data and finding
Absolutely.
The differences in the patterns. Humans take about 10 minutes and they're like, oh, okay, too much.
And it helps cut down the man hours, right?
And it does. It cuts down the man hours. It increases the accuracy. You filter out a lot of the noise. You can enrich the data so that the analyst, when the analyst actually, when it gets to that level and the analyst is actually looking at it, they're like, oh, I've got this, 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 and this all put together, and that means I need to do X, Y, and Z. And they don't have to go hunting for that needle in the haystack because the machine has already found all the needles and go, hey, you got six of them, what do you want to do? Hey, okay, great. That a human can go through and make a much faster decision right now than a machine would be able to do because we can take a different context to it and move forward. It's getting to that point where we can actually hit that. That is really the key of what we're talking about.
Wow, that's some really good stuff, Jerry. Can you tell our viewers and listeners how they could learn more about CGI Federal and how they can contact you?
Sure. The easiest way to learn more about CGI Federal is you can go to CGI.com and go to our federal page. It's one of the business units there. They can contact me if they contact me at jerry.jenkins@cgifederal.com. I'd be more than happy to talk to you about anything you'd like to hear.
All right, Jerry, thanks so much for stopping by.
Thank you very much.